So see here, this 1 radian, this I said it is 1 radian, right? This 1 radian in terms of degree, you will have some value, right? Yes or no? So I want to find out 1 radian is equal to how much degree? Obviously, it will be a big value, right? Big degree. So we want to find out. So how we will find out? With the help of this. So you can see here, pi, I can bring this side, right? Like for example, some of you may not understand this one. 100 centimeter is equal to how much? 1 meter, right? So I want to find out 1 centimeter is equal to how much? 100, bring this side. So it will be 1 meter by 100. So you can see this 100, when I bring this side, what will be left out here? 1 centimeter. Same way here also. I want to find out 1 radian is equal to how much. So what I will do, this pi I will bring this side. Okay, so what will be left out here? 1 radian. Okay, so 1 radian is equal to how much? 180 by pi. Now you know the value of pi, right? From lower class you have been studying this value. So if I put that value, 3.14 something, right? If I put that one in the calculator, so you can see 180 divided by, I will put pi here. Can you see 57.29577, this value, this degree, this much amount you will get. That is, here how much you will get? Where is the relation? Okay, anyway, I will write here. 1 radian, how much you will get? 180 by pi is equal to how much you will get? 57.2977 something you got, right? So you can see 1 radian is equal to how much? 57 point. Right now here I have written 29 degree, but this is not valid, okay? Right now you don't know how to convert into minute and second. That we will discuss in the exercise only. So when I will discuss that, you will understand that this point value how to write down, okay? Remember, degree you cannot write in terms of point like this, okay? So for your understanding right now, I'm writing. So 1 degree, 1 radian, basically it is 57 degree point something. Okay, so you can understand, when you draw angle in terms of radian, if you measure this one in terms of degree, this 1 radian, if you measure in terms of degree, it will be 57 degree point something value. Okay? So how big this angle is. Okay, so same way, if you want to find out 1 degree, it will be how much radian. So you know it will be very, very small number, because 1 radian itself is equal to 57 degree. So 1 degree will be how much? You know that it will be very 0 point something you will get, very small. Okay, so right now we don't need all those values. This is for your understanding only. Okay, so basically what we need now is pi. We have derived it is equal to how much? 180 degree. This is pi's measurement in terms of radian, and this is in terms of degree. Okay, so that 3.14, right now you have understood, I guess, right? In lower class you have used, right, pi is equal to 3.14 most of the time. Now when you used to use pi, you used to use whenever there is an angle, okay? Like for example, 2 pi r, many formulas are there, right? For volume of something you used to have pi. In case of cone, you used to have pi, right? So wherever there is angle, you will see pi will be there. Okay, why? Because pi is nothing but it is an angle measurement. Okay, and what is the value? 3.14, and in terms of degree it is 180 degree. So that's why I said, you can see here, when I said in terms of radian, this will be 2 radian, then 3 radian, then I said point something, right? So you can see this is in terms of degree, you know, right? This is 180 degree. Yes, this is 180 degree, and in terms of pi it will be 3 point something. You can see from the graph only, you can understand from the diagram, I mean 3.14. That's why 180 degree it is written as 3.14. So this you didn't know in lower class, so try to understand from now on. But okay, pi is nothing but measurement of angle. Okay, so this is the shortcut I have written here. Whenever you have to convert degree into radian, radian into degree, this is the formula we are going to use. So I will show you in the next class only how to use this equation to find out any degree. For example, if I ask you 30 degree, write down in terms of radian how much it is. I can use this relation and I can directly find out what will be the radian value of 30 degree. Okay, if I want to find out 1 radian is equal to how much in terms of degree, that also I can. So whatever degree you want to convert into radian or radian into degree, always use this relation. Okay, this is the shortcut. So this is not given in your textbook, so better you note down this one, and you can use this one anywhere, means in your exam also you can use this equation to find out radian in terms of degree, degree in terms of radian. So in the next class only I will discuss this one in detail, how to use this. Okay, so right now try to understand pi is equal to 180 degree and try to understand this definition carefully, whatever I have explained. Okay, I know this is quite complicated right now because this is totally new for you. Okay, but when we will do problems, then you will understand the importance of all this definitions. Okay.